hard for you. How are you?
Hey, Sputter. I haven't talked to you in a while.
Hey, Big Jack. How are you, baby?
Sierra is talking to her fans tonight.
Are y'all having a great weekend?
With just a digital camera and a high-speed internet connection, she streams live video and interacts with people around the world.
For five gold, you'll get a Flash baby doll.
But Sierra will do more than just talk. She's creating amateur porn, all from the comfort of her own home. Internet technology has transformed pornography as we know it. It's available on over 24 million sites with the promise of anonymity and unlimited access. Everyday people are now creating erotic videos for upload and conducting live sex sessions in bedrooms across America, and millions are watching.
Every couple has sex. We just do it live on a website.
But it can be a dangerous world where fantasy can invade reality.
When you receive that attention, it's like a fueling fire. I didn't feel like anything could stop me.
This story is about secret lives, about adult men and women who have ventured into the world of amateur porn and the consequences that can come along with that journey.
Come on, baby, you're coming in. Let's go. Come on in.
America, it can be inspiring and beautiful. It can also be dark and ugly. It's so many things, but it's ours. It's our America. In the deep South, in a middle-class suburban neighborhood, I'm heading into a world where nothing is what it seems.
This is not the area I'd expect amateur porn to be taking place, but it just goes to show that you never know what goes on behind closed doors.
Amateur porn is a phenomena that's been secretly growing, reaching all different kinds of communities across America. In one of them, I'm about to meet a woman who's living a very unexpected, very hidden, and unusual life.
You ready? Action.
50-year-old Sierra is making amateur porn with her husband, Patrick, of 20 years.
That looks awesome. We need a little more of a strut than that. Okay, turn around and look at me.
In their home with Patrick behind the camera, the couple creates erotic photos and videos of Sierra to upload to amateur sites.
I never imagined that we would be doing this.
It's sort of like a hobby that we have come to learn to do together. He likes to shoot, and I like to pose. I like to dress up. He likes to take pictures.
I guess that's another take.
It's hard to stand in these shoes.
Fortunately, we're not using film.
That's all tangled up.
We're gonna start back over from here.
I know, dear. Mr. Producer, I got it. Just trying to get the wardrobe malfunction straightened out.
Commercial pornography bores the hell out of me. I'm a very sexual person, but porn itself is so repetitive that you've watched one and you've pretty much seen them all.
Slowly take off the white and we're gonna drop it to the ground.
We try to put a little art into it and make it a little more tasteful than what I see a lot of people do.
Play with the hat a little bit and then toss it off to the side.
I just really don't think of it as pornography. I think of it as adult entertainment.
Very good. Excellent. Great job.
Want to see my closet?
Yes. This bathroom alone is very impressive.
For just over a year, unbeknownst to everyone but Patrick, Sierra has been nurturing this secret hobby and loving it.
Well, those are my work shoes.
Those are some serious stripper shoes.
Yeah, you have to practice to walk in most of those.
More than half of her closet contains costumes, props for the many roles she plays in the porn she and Patrick create.
My favorite one is this one.
With the feathers.
Oh, and I'm all about some feathers. Is that not
this glorious?
I adore it. I absolutely adore it.
I feel like I'm in Las Vegas and I'm on the stage and I've got one of those big headdresses on that match these.
So this is, I mean, this is kind of like sort of role-playing for you.
It is. It's dress-up. It's fantasy. I'm living out my fantasy, and they also think I'm a fantasy.
So it's fun for you.
It's way fun. I love dress-up. I get to be anybody I want to be.
Sierra seems to play the secret role well, but to the outside world, she plays another one entirely. By day, she dresses conservatively, the quintessential Southern belle. She's a mother and a grandmother who frequents society cocktail parties and the country club with her friends.
I have said that I live the country club life, I'm the country club wife, and that is true on the outside as far as my day-to-day life. Then I have the other life of Sierra, and I am very capable of keeping those two people separate.
In social circles, Sierra is known as one half of a loving couple, one that formed 20 years ago when she married her soulmate, Patrick. Over the next two decades, they lived like any other American couple, raising a family and enjoying the profits from a successful real estate business they run together.
We're gonna look at the paint first.
Yes, I think that's our best bet. We just need to do a flat ceiling white. It's a small little bathroom.
I agree.
But when the recession hit a few years ago, the couple wanted to find a way to maintain the comfortable lifestyle they'd built.
And flooring is also, I think, on this side, isn't it?
It is.
But we didn't want to sell the house because the market's so depressed and most of our equity's in the house. So I first had two part-time jobs at the mall just so we could maintain.
That's when Sierra's friend told her about an amateur porn site where uploaded erotic photos and videos earn cash. Sierra saw an opportunity to bring in some extra money and explore something she'd always been curious about.
It was something that I wanted to say I'd done in my life, that I shot porn. I'd rank it right up there with winning American Idol or being in a rock band and traveling around on tour.
She tells me the very first photo she posted brought an unexpected offer, a professional porn shoot in Miami worth thousands of dollars.
I thought to myself, you know, this is a once-in-a-lifetime deal, and I may never get the opportunity or the option again. And the pay was great.
So what happened?
You don't know who you're gonna get till they walk in the door and they introduce you and say, this is so-and-so and you're gonna be shooting with him today.
You're gonna be having sex with him.
Right.
How weird is that? How
it's
awkward.
Weird. It's very weird. I'm telling you, I was shaking. But I asked for it and I felt like I had to give them what they were looking for.
But it seems like it was kind of traumatizing.
Well, it was. I mean, I just wasn't prepared for what it entailed. And I didn't realize I was giving up control, but I did. You do it the way they want to do it. I just was naive and did not understand that.
While professional porn was not what Sierra envisioned, Patrick, who initially supported her participation, was also disillusioned.
I spent a few sessions with my therapist afterwards to come to grips with it. The thing that probably bothered me the most was that I lost control. I couldn't be on the set. I couldn't look after her.
Sierra and Patrick vowed never to lose control again and found a way for Sierra to take part in this world that was comfortable for them both. Now, several times a week, Sierra prepares to live cam, a real-time video web session where she broadcasts solo sex acts to users on amateur sites. She's an online fantasy in a world where every minute, nearly 2 million people are viewing porn.
Everybody is on the internet at some point or time, whether they're CEO or the man who's washing the gutters for you. I could have a rocket scientist on one end, and I could have a trash collector on the other. My fans are used to me having a cocktail. They always ask, what are you drinking? all about the perception.
Sierra's online persona, a housewife living a life of leisure, calls for a cocktail, a prop she says eases inhibitions. From the bedroom she shares with her husband, Sierra logs on. It's 2 p.m. on a Sunday, the most popular day in America for viewing internet porn.
Hey, Studley. Hey, Thomas.
Hey. Hey, Plum Bomb. Have you missed me? Kiss this doll.
Sierra has offered to show me this interactive world firsthand.
Cheers, babies.
A world where she entices men and women to pay her to star exclusively in their own sexual fantasies.
You're horny. Oh, baby. I would love to role play for you an exclusive, sweetheart.
It sounds like she's talking to
about
three different men.
I've been working. I'm ready.
And she's waiting for someone to take her private. And when that happens, she does what he tells her to do. It looks like it's happening.
You want to see it all.
Well, you came to the right place, sweet angel. You like?
Sierra tries to secure these private sessions for at least an hour every day. If successful, at the end of the week, she'll take home up to $600.
I'm back. Well, hey, boob man. How old are you? 21's perfect, baby. Oh, I do like younger guys. They're my fave. If you're legal, I love you. I am your sexy cougar, baby. Cheers!
So, among the men Sierra is talking to is a 19-year-old.
I'm your fantasy. That is so sweet, baby. Mommy would love to go private with you, the one. That would be awesome. And I will help you through anything you need to work through, baby. Do you love your mother? You do. Oh, Mommy loves you too, baby.
Okay, that was unbelievable. You had about 15 solicitations and 3 privates. And how many of them wanted you to be mommy?
2.
Are you surprised by how many young men fantasize about their mothers?
Oh, yeah. I'm not sure why. I don't have an answer for you there. I just know that that's who my audience is. And because of my age, I'm filling that role for them in their fantasy. This is the world of sex now. And
you're one of the stars.
And I'm just happy to be a part of it because why not?
At the age of 50, Sierra has embraced a new generation of porn where remote intimacy is possible and consequences seem distant. It's enabled her to live out a fantasy and maintain her lifestyle. Less than 100 miles away, another family has entered this world, but for them, the stakes are much higher.
Hey. Yeah.
24-year-old Tyler and 21-year-old Berkeley seem like a typical young American couple.
Hey, you. What are you doing?
They start their morning like any other parents, waking their 20-month-old daughter and preparing for the day.
Ooh.
We spend from sunup till sundown with the baby.
No! No! Who's that? Who's that over there?
She pretty well owns this house. It's pretty much hers.
Can I see him?
But neither Tyler or Berkeley will head out to a day job. Their work is done at home. 5 nights a week after their daughter goes to bed, they, like Sierra, make amateur porn. For them, it's the way they've chosen to make a living to support their child. But will it come with a price?
Woohoo!
Young parents Tyler and Berkeley spend their days caring for their daughter.
Want it?
The high school sweethearts have been on and off again for 5 years. But when Berkeley got pregnant at 19, the two worked hard to stay together, to create a family. But that wasn't easy. Just 8 months ago, Tyler and Berkeley were struggling to make ends meet, and their parents couldn't offer any financial support.
I've never had money growing up. He's never had money growing up. We've always pinched pennies.
Without a college degree, Berkeley was only able to get short-term work as a cocktail waitress in a nightclub. And Tyler could only get jobs that made less than $350 a week.
It did get to the point where we weren't making enough money. If I would have lost my job, we would have had nothing. You know, we would have been without.
Tyler's taking me on a tour of his past to the place where he and Berkeley landed when they hit rock bottom.
This is my family's property. It's a family farm. This is where we came because it's all we had. It's just so far out in the middle of nowhere. There's nothing.
They were living in an unfinished cabin in the woods, 15 miles from the nearest town.
And it has no air conditioning?
No air conditioning whatsoever.
It is hot to death. So is this exactly how it was when you were living in it for the most part?
The grass was cut. That was the difference.
Well, I can see how you wouldn't want your daughter crawling around here.
No, not at all. You have splinters.
Yeah.
The fireplace, it's always been really dangerous. I mean, there's cracks from where it's breaking. And we've had problems with snakes coming in through here. But this, at one point in time, was what we used to keep this place warm.
How cold did it get in here?
It got cold enough that the refrigerators would shut off because it got colder in the house than it would in the refrigerator, like it was in the refrigerator, which is pretty cold.
Tyler tells me there was little spare cash to turn this shack into a safe home for their daughter.
You can tell, like, the ceiling's starting to sag up here. And
this place is gonna crumble pretty soon.
It's gonna slide down this hill. It's gonna go right on down the hill. This was no place to raise a kid at all. I just don't ever wanna come back to this or live like this ever again, you know?
To get out of this place, out of the hole they were in, Tyler and Berkeley decided to try something Berkeley had heard about from a friend.
So how did you get into porn?
I introduced it to him, and we started making a lot of money doing couples online.
Was it an easy decision to do it?
We did it once together that first night. Within like 30 minutes, we had made $300. And I was like, I'm done with the normal 40-hour week, I'm done. We usually take 2 or 3 days off a week, still make $1,000, you know? It's got us a way better life, and it's worth it.
I mean, you're just totally comfortable being out there doing what you do.
And I don't like feeling like it is a deep, dark secret. And we've gotten...
We're proud of it.
We are proud. We're very proud of it.
Because how good we do, we're proud of it. We don't feel like we should have to hide it no more.
No.
What is it? Woo!
We have responsibilities as parents to do good.
It's really important to me to be a good mom and give my daughter a better life than me and Tyler have both had.
We just want to be normal. That's what our goal is to be, is just to be normal as possible.
But no matter how hard they try to create a normal life, is raising their daughter in the shadow of amateur porn truly normal?
What are some of the strangest things that people have asked you to do?
Domination kind of things. Like people like to be ordered around to doing things.
Brother, sister.
Hair pulling, biting.
Yeah, a lot of hair pulling, and that hurts, something like that.
And where's your daughter at this time?
She's asleep on the other end of the place.
Are you concerned about how you're going to talk to your daughter about this? Because she is getting older and going to be in school soon.
I'm hoping by then we won't be doing it seriously anymore. I want to grab some sort of trade, you know what I mean? Like, I want to learn how to do air conditioning, refrigeration. The goal is to not do this full-time all the time. This kind of job is helping us get closer and closer to college. Hey, you want to put your pajamas on?
Yes,
While Tyler and Berkeley aren't able to save for college just yet, the $1,000 a week they make from porn enables them to finally live a comfortable life.
Hey, want to wear this? I don't want to be broke, and I want my child to be broke, and I don't want to live a broke life. I want to live a comfortable, happy life. Porn's giving it, and I'm gonna take it.
But a life that includes a family and amateur porn can be complicated. For now, Berkeley and Tyler's daughter is too young to understand what her parents do for a living.
Whee!
They have a few more years before they'll have to tell her or get out of porn.
All right, let's go. Let's go get something to eat.
This is the reality Sierra is just about to face. She too has a daughter, one who is fully grown and until now has known nothing about Sierra's porn career, a career that is expanding quickly. Sierra and Patrick have started her very own website and are now pulling in up to $3,000 a month. But for them, it's not just about the money. They're finding this world more thrilling every day.
When I think about someone else watching her perform on camera, I don't have one inkling of jealousy because I know what the process is. I'm proud of her popularity.
It's interesting, it's exciting, it's fun. It continues to amaze me every single day.
Put the hat down beside your leg.
But as amateur porn increasingly becomes the reality, so do its possible consequences. After keeping her daughter in the dark for more than a year, Sierra finally feels it's time to come clean.
So tonight's the night you're gonna tell your daughter?
Yeah. Good or bad, tonight's the night. I don't want somebody else to tell her.
Or to find out accidentally.
Or to find out accidentally. I mean, I think that would hurt her more than anything that I, you know, didn't step up to the plate and tell her the truth. I think she'll be in shock. But who wouldn't be? To find out your 50-year-old mother is doing this. I mean, she'll tell you that I'm her best friend. And anybody else who asks, my mama's my best friend.
Has it been hard to keep this from your best friend for so long?
Very hard. Yeah, very hard. It's gonna be the hardest thing I've ever done. But I gotta do it, you know? I don't really have a choice. I gotta do it.
Sierra's only just beginning to deal with the risk of participating in a world that, though hidden, is still taboo. But what happens when a person becomes truly entrenched in this world? I was about to get a glimpse of just how damaging years in amateur porn could be. In the middle of the country, I'm about to meet a couple whose experience with amateur porn nearly destroyed everything that mattered to them.
Coming to get you.
Aw, come get it, buddy.
Is he?
25-year-old Julie and 27-year-old Richard have been together for 5 years. Their world revolves around their children and each other.
You getting dizzy?
But for the past 3 years, their love has been put to the test, and for the sake of their family, they've now decided to put amateur porn behind them.
This has done a number on us. It's caused problems with our family. It's caused problems in our sex life. It's caused problems with how we function day to day.
In the end, I lost control, and I think it's better that I did. It wasn't until my world came crashing down around me that I woke up and saw how it affected the way I interacted with my children, with my husband, and it was a painful realization.
To get to this perspective has been a long and difficult road, one that began before Julie had even met Richard. At just 18 years old, she started live camming, engaging in online video chats where viewers directed her in their sexual fantasies.
It was empowering to an unhealthy level. I felt like I had control over these men, married men, men who have girlfriends.
While she felt in charge, what drew Julie to this world, the need for control, was born from a dark place, something haunting from her past. At the age of 4, Julie was sexually abused by a man she thought she could trust. It happened again at age 6, and at 9, by 2 other men.
It was a traumatic experience the first time, and each consecutive time after, it was like reliving a nightmare. That just got worse. Throughout my teenage years, I continued to subject myself into abusive relationships. Mentally, verbally, sexually, I was an object.
In amateur porn, Julie found a place that felt familiar, an extension of her distorted past where she felt her self-worth was measured in sex.
There was a part of me that was still craving that negative attention because that's what I had been used to all my life.
It wasn't until she met Richard in a music chat room that things began to change for her. Richard was different.
He didn't sexualize me. He didn't objectify me. And that was something that I hadn't experienced in a relationship before. I knew that he was the person that I wanted to spend my life with because he understood me for who I was, and he accepted me for who I was.
But even with the love and support of her new husband, Julie couldn't give up exposing herself on the internet.
Why did you feel the need to continue camming after you were married?
I felt like it was a part of me. As normal as it is for someone to wake up and brush their teeth, it was normal for me to expose myself on cam.
Julie tells me she then dove deeper into her habit, convincing Richard to join her on an online couple site.
Did you ever do it for the money?
No. We have made money off of it, but it was never
specifically for that.
It was a big confidence boost when we both started doing it together, for the both of us.
It was a big ego boost to me. I am incredibly self-conscious about my body and appearance, always have been.
The fact that I was having people say that I was attractive, I've never used a feeling like this.
But is it like an adrenaline thing?
It
like
is.
Exposing yourself and doing these things to kind of random, anonymous people.
Gives a sense of power. You know, everybody would say, you know, oh, you're such a lucky guy. And I mean, I'd be like, I know.
Come on, let's clean up our beds. Here, let's start with yours, buddy.
For Julie and Richard, life went on. Everything seemed normal, in control. In the privacy of their own home, having sex live online felt safe and untraceable. It became a nightly ritual. But just 3 months later, they were blindsided by something they never thought could happen.
We found out we were being recorded and spread through multiple websites and downloaded by thousands of people.
Being able to do just a simple search, I was able to find our pictures. It scared the utter bejesus out of me.
Live camming, supposedly an exclusive one-time event, had gone viral.
The online world appears to be safe, but you're never truly anonymous. It's not safe.
This scare was enough to keep Richard from live camming ever again. But Julie, though initially shocked, found she couldn't give up this world entirely.
Careful, it's hot.
You set it on the table for me?
Hey, 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 no more stirring, baby. Put it in the microwave.
Now, where are the plates?
In the weeks after they discovered videos of their sex sessions spread on the internet, Julie and Richard worked hard to keep life on track. But deep down, Julie felt a pull, a need to feed an addiction she had unknowingly formed over the years. She continued to live cam on her own.
If I would go an extended period of time without being on camera, I felt like I was going through withdrawal of that type of social interaction because that's what I had been used to all my life.
Richard tried to come to grips with the fact that his wife wouldn't give up this world.
I was like, okay, either I'm going to have to deal with this or we're going to have to consider some other option.
I wasn't okay with it, but I ended up biting my tongue.
More and more, the attention Julie once gave Richard was now focused on her online performances, on her male viewers.
It was causing conflict in our marriage. It was affecting the way we interacted with each other, how much time we spent with each other, how affectionate we were to each other.
To satisfy his own needs, Richard found himself drawn back to online porn. But this time, he chose not to perform, but to become a consumer. What started as curiosity quickly spiraled out of control.
I started getting a little too into it to where it was something that was a part of my life. It was a part of my day. I was able to detract from reality. It's almost like if I hadn't had a cigarette for a long time, I start feeling that, hey, hey, you need a cigarette. You need a cigarette. It's that same thing for, hey, hey, you need to go view this material.
Richard began to download thousands of pornographic pictures and videos onto the family computer. But his secret stash, his escape from their reality, was soon uncovered when Julie decided to organize their computer files.
I just felt like my world came crashing down around me as I went through picture after picture after picture. I was hurt, I was shocked, I was disgusted, not just with him, but with myself. It was then that I realized that I had a problem and my husband had a problem. And we each had our individual issues that we needed to work through.
Porn had seeped into their daily lives and taken over.
After all this unraveled, it became really hard for me to be intimate.
We've only made love once since this took place. That was 6 months ago.
Having grown so far apart, they knew they needed help. Now, after years of secrets and denial, they're headed to their very first couples counseling session.
You know, I'm here with you every step of the way.
We've got a long road ahead of us in our marriage. You know, we've got a lot of ground to make up, a lot of work to do. I won't lose my wife and kids to this because this is not as important to me as my family.
I'm scared, but I'm prepared. And I'm ready to face it. Now it's time for me to let it go.
Julie and Richard begin a long and difficult journey to try to overcome their addictions and salvage their relationship. Back in the suburbs of the Deep South, I couldn't help but think of Sierra. Where was she in her own journey? When I last saw her, she was leaving to finally tell her daughter her secret, that she'd been doing amateur porn, something that would be hard for any daughter to hear.
How'd it go?
It didn't go well at all.
So what happened?
She was so devastated. She said, "You're going to ruin everything I've worked so hard for if the people I work with see what you've been doing." And I said, "That was not my intent ever to hurt you or to ruin your life or to jeopardize your career." I said, "But the bottom line is, this is something that's been in the works for over a year. We have an investment here. So I can't just tuck my little tail because my feelings are hurt or I hurt her feelings and run. That would be wrong of me. That would make me not the person I am."
But do you think it's worth this relationship? And
I don't ever think anything's worth breaking somebody's heart, certainly not your child's heart. I hope and I pray that she'll come around. And I'll just have to take it one day at a time, one step at a time. It's all I can do. It's all I can do. Yeah.
But you can turn back if you want to, can't you?
I guess I could turn back.
But you're choosing not to.
I think I'm not. I don't think I'm gonna turn back.
Clearly, Sierra is conflicted, caught between two worlds, her allegiance to her daughter and her own desires. For now, she's unwilling to give up her new career, despite the price she may pay. And I just wonder if in the end, it'll be worth it.
There's my girl. There you go. There you go. Get him off. Let me see if you got everything.
Rinse it off. Can I rinse it off? Good girl. That's a good girl.
It's the end of the day for Tyler and Berkeley. Time to tuck their daughter safely into bed. in time to prepare for their nightly live cam session, to enter a world that seems safe and anonymous for them, but has been a minefield for others. But for Berkeley and Tyler, the only downside so far is the reality of sex for work, starting around midnight, 5 nights a week.
Having sex off and on for 2-3 hours, it's kind of hard, especially like the kind they want is like rough. So it wears on you a lot.
Because it is a job for us to have sex with one another, sex outside of work doesn't really happen. It's a total sex killer.
You've just spent the last half hour or so preparing for a performance.
Yeah.
So this is your bedroom, but it's also your set.
This is where it goes down.
Yeah.
And your daughter is asleep upstairs.
Mm-hmm. Sound asleep.
We keep a baby monitor turned down really low, so if we do hear a rustling or anything, you know, we'll sign out, go tend to her, and usually come right back to work. As long as it's a good time to work, we'll work. When we can make the money quick, we do.
That time is now. As final preparations are made, I step out to leave them to their work. It's now these two young parents begin to turn into amateur porn stars.
Hi, boys.
Outside, I sign on to witness what Tyler and Berkeley's hundreds of viewers will see. This site is just one of 24 million pornographic websites out there, available 24 hours a day. There's something for everyone. Gay, bondage, couples.
So Berkeley and Tyler are in the bedroom. Tyler needs a little time to get excited, so we and all of their clients are waiting.
Those clients will pay up to $7 a minute, and 75% of that goes to the hosting website. But with the amount of traffic Tyler and Berkeley get, they say it's still worth it.
Tyler and Berkeley were on for maybe less than a minute, and immediately they got into a private, so someone is paying to watch them perform right now.
For now, Berkeley and Tyler remain unaware that amateur porn can destroy lives. And they, like others I had met, may not realize this until it's too late. Sierra has not spoken to her daughter further about her new career. And despite the initial negative reaction, she's pushing onward, tucking away her emotional turmoil and plunging even deeper into her work. She and Patrick are taking their business to the next level as they begin to include other amateurs in the porn they produce.
Tennis is awesome.
Heck yes, I am so ready. I'll let it hang loose. There you go.
A young woman, another aspiring porn star, has flown over 2,000 miles to film with them. She's one of the first of many models they hope to represent in the future.
If they're willing to give us a chance, we're willing to work as hard as we can for them. I hope it ends up making their dreams come true.
Awesome, awesome. This is gonna be a really, really good shoot, I think.
I think so too.
If we don't contribute, and hopefully in a positive way, somebody else is going to do it anyway. And maybe not as well as we do it.
Ready to shoot?
We are ready to shoot.
Awesome. We're ready.
Heck yeah.
Premise is gonna be her son is out of town. You've been playing tennis. She pulled a calf muscle.
Okay.
A little bit of skin. This is something y'all have both been waiting for, the perfect opportunity. Okay, different position. A little kiss.
It's entertainment. And what we're selling is entertainment.
But delving deeper into this world of entertainment may jeopardize more than just Sierra's relationship with her own daughter.
A little bit towards me. Naughty look. What you gonna do to each other?
That's good. We're gonna be bad girls.
Oh, too bad.
she faces a community that may not embrace her choices.
There's a whole lot of people who severely look down on this.
Oh, I know.
Say it's immoral and it tears marriages apart.
I think it keeps them together. We're far more intimate than we were when I was 40.
You're more intimate.
Oh, yes. Your mind becomes open to other things to experiment with, and we've become a lot closer because of that.
What happens when your friends find out about this or find out about your life?
I honestly don't know. We may have to leave town. We've discussed it, that we may have to leave town.
Is it worth the risk then?
To be able to promote my side and me, it's worth it to me.
Mesmerized by the fantasy, by the taste of success, Sierra is now willing to give up almost everything for her new career. And while she and Patrick shed their former lives, Julie and Richard still work to reclaim theirs. For them, every day is a struggle to reject the impulses of the past.
Essentially, we are trying to keep porn out of our lives. I really have found a way to redirect my urges and my need, so to speak, into more productive things such as cleaning or chain smoking.
What I hope for is that I'll be able to heal. I just want to be able to be content and not to feel like I have a shadow looming over me.
While Julie and Richard chart their course to a future without amateur porn, Tyler and Berkeley focus on the present, on living the life they've always wanted for their daughter.
I really want her to know everything we went through, that life isn't easy, that you do have to struggle sometimes. This got us started on a better life. I mean, who's to say what's bad and what's good?
Each of the people I met engaged in amateur porn for a variety of reasons, and for each, the experience has had its rewards and consequences. For me, this has been a glimpse into a world that unfolds behind closed doors, one that is now an integral part of America's sexual reality.